Today on Made to Hack, I make an ATX benchtop power supply. A benchtop power supply is an indispensable tool for any electronics hobbyist. One of the easiest and most affordable ways to get a power supply is to use an old computer ATX power supply. I've been using mine for quite a while, but I made some mistakes when I first built it. The mains power switch does not work properly and I wanted to redo the case. In this video, I go over the disassembly and reassembly of the ATX power supply and the wiring diagram. I first began by taking apart the old ATX power supply and removing the binding posts. I disconnect and resolder the mains power cable on the board. I reattach the C14 power jack to the new case. And I then rewire the mains power switch to the supply. I then reattach the board to the case. I drill holes for the binding posts and connect them. The binding posts are connected to their color-coded wires and isolated with heat shrink tubing. These are the wiring colors corresponding to the different ATX voltages. The blue wires are for negative 12 volts, the yellow wires are for positive 12 volts. The orange wires are for positive 3.3 volts. I didn't have an orange binding post, so I used green. The red wires are connected to positive 5 volts, and finally the black wires are ground. You don't have to use different colored binding posts, I just find it's quick reference to use. With the binding posts done, I connected a 10 ohm, 10 watt load resistor between positive 5 volts and ground. A modern ATX PSU will not work unless there is a load between 5 volts and ground or 12 volts and ground. I then also connected the power switch, which turns on the different supply voltages. The small power switch is connected between the power on wire, which is green, and ground. When this switch is flipped, the various power rails are turned on. I also connected a red LED between the 5V standby wire, which is purple, and ground. This LED turns on when you provide mains power to your power supply. I then also connected a green LED between 5V and ground. This LED turns on when you flip the small power switch and it shows that all the power rails are activated. You can also see the 10 ohm, 10 watt load resistor connected between 5V and ground. You can also use a 5 ohm, 10 watt resistor, but this will draw twice the power. I found a 10 ohm resistor sufficient to provide load for my PSU. With everything assembled, this is the ATX PSU working. When plugged into mains voltage, the mains power switch turns on. When that switch is turned on, the red LED turns on to let us know standby mode is activated. The power rails are not yet on, but it does indicate that the PSU has mains power. With the small switch turned on, the green LED turns on, letting us know that the power rails are activated. And I checked that all the voltages are correct as they should be. If you've modified an old ATX PSU to use as a benchtop power supply, let me know in the comments below and share your projects with everyone. Hey, thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Also, make sure to turn on notifications to receive updates whenever I post a new video. If you like what you saw, hit that like button as well.